swallow the food under the water. He can take you under there, and he'll drown you, but to swallow it, you'll have to do what he did then. Raise his head up. Because if you look down at Croc Strait, you can't see anything. It's a modified tongue. It means they can swim through the water with your leg in their mouth, but they're not going to drown. To swallow your leg, you must raise his head right out. In excess of half a ton, 500 kilograms. To lift this body up out of the water now is a big effort. Right, so he'll work pretty hard for this. What just happens repetitively? So it's a repetitive action. It's not something that we can get in there one day. Well, I think she's just down there. She'll keep out the way normally while this is going on. I think there's a big hole in that fence too.
Oh, thanks.
A big what?
How old?
Conservation. I'll lighten it up with a little story for you. Right, because you're all on holidays. Say all of you folks here this morning, you're headed up the Daintree River, you got yourself on a cruise boat, and you're cruising down the Daintree. You had a pretty good guide, and your guide suggested he saw 10 nests along the banks. What does a croc nest look like? You can all have a look at one in a minute. Estuarine crocs nest in the wet. Right, we've had a taste of it. Prawns, barramundi, and a hell of a lot of other things. You'll sustainably use the Daintree National Park while you're here. You'll sustainably use the Great Barrier Reef. We all pay for the privilege, and part of what we pay should go back to the management, the research and the conservation. What I'm trying to suggest, as long as the government doesn't interfere, you may have guaranteed the survival of the estuarine crocs. Yes, here we go.
Not all the time there, yeah.
It's 6:30. Right, folks, see up the end there, see all the guinea grass?